let's start with location. I believe in location karma. I believe location matters. I believe you can be the same person and live in the wrong location, and it can make a difference. Where you live on the earth, when you live in a place, can make a big difference. Currently, as of June 28th, 2024, I'm located in a place called Denver, Colorado. The BD Grill since 1992. When I arrived here to Denver after being away 15 years in the spring of 2022, I lived here from August 1990, age 37, all the way to January 2009. So when I returned with my 2017 Prius touring that I bought in San Diego, I would start in the spring of 2022, and BD Grill was the place I went every single day for a beer at the grill. After I drove Lyft in the morning, well, after I got on the Lyft platform, May, I would drive in the morning and go to the BD Grill midday, and I would end up filming or videotaping the crew and got to know them very well. And this is Diane from the BD Grill. Diane.
You want a knife, sir?
What's that?
You want a knife?
Pretty amazing.
Everyone singing in the stadium.
Yeah.
And the
Niners, Cardinals came to Mexico. Supérame porque ya te olvidé.
Ay, mira, no,
tú que sabes mentir, ya cambié de corazón y tú no vuelves a entrar aquí. Ya supérame, que no te arda estar sin mí.
Yeah. Wow. Hi. Now what are you doing, Migo?
I'm pouring some shots of Mi Campo Blanco tequila. You see that?
Yeah.
Jack Daniels.
I'm a monk. I can't drink.
Oh, well, this is water. Can you drink water?
Yeah, I'm a monk. And I said, fuck the monk. So,
I mean,
what
are you
going to
do?
Someone's partying. This partying, yeah?
No, me too.
I guess I'm partying too.
No, you're farting.
I'm still working on my beer.
Not me.
You're farting?
What do you mean by farting?
Oi.
Oi.
I think what I'm going to do when I have the four barking dogs next door, I'm going to get two dogs that bark. And they can all bark together.
And then he would play for us every once in a while. He made me learn piano first.
Oh, okay.
So.
We're giving an interview to Tanner, bro.
Yeah, this is Tanner.
So I learned piano when I was like 6 years old for a couple years.
What is that?
Oh, okay. And that's his friend, Diane. Cling, cling. Es una entrevista, mira.
Ask.
Ask him a question.
Where did you start playing? Where were you living when you first started playing guitar?
I was living in my parents' house in Broomfield.
Broomfield, okay.
Yeah, you sound good.
He sang. Hey, yeah, see.
You sing?
Not
well. Okay, do it. You didn't sing. Sing too.
When the Elton John, that's what you played, right? What's that one called?
That was Leonard Skinner.
That's Leonard Skinner.
Simple Man. Yeah. Simple Man, yeah. Oh my God, yeah.
My mama said.
Oh, look, he's in here. I got you.
No, get in there, dude.
This is a good studio. Get in there. Get in there. Don't be a pussy. Oh, Doug's a pussy. Look at him.
I don't know the words to this song.
Mama told me.
When I was young.
Be a simple man.
Oh, there you go.
I'm a country man. I'm a country man with a country plan.
Oh, here he goes. Oh my God, Doug's coming out. No. Performance by Tanner Brown and Doug Wirma.
I have the sub dude. I have my sub dude. I'm the dude, man. I'm the main dude. Here at Legal Pete's. What's he up? Knows exactly, and this is the young lady. This is all the gang. Everyone here is cool, man.
Yeah.
I come here every day and they get to know me.
Yeah.
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 And they have chips and salsa.
What's up, Tokyo?
Tokyo, what's up? Say hi to Tokyo.
What's up, Tokyo? I love it.
No, seriously.
Mac, do you mind?
I've been in Tokyo five times.
Thanks, what's up, guys?
He's making me a burrito with white rice, black beans, barbacoa, Illegal Pete's, right around the corner from where I live.
Illegal Pete's Denver.
All my friends in Tokyo, this is my main dude.
What's up, guys? Are we doing, you said chicken or you want to do beef?
We'll do beef.
There you go. See, Doug used to get chicken alive.
I know I used to get chicken. I'm kind of switched
up. He switched it up.
He knows.
I know.
He knows it.
Wait for that.
I know. There's no rush, bro.
How you been?
I'm.
What's new? You still making? You still just every day?
Every day making videos.
How many you done today so far?
I've done 4 already.
Nice. Nice. You drive this morning?
Yeah, I drove this morning, made $100 already.
Yeah, there you go.
I should be your 69-year-old hero, dude.
You are, man. There you go. All right,
I've already made my $100 video.
You already made your quota.
Yeah.
There you go.
My video with you.
I love it. So this is how Doug likes it. You gotta get everything. Everything in there.
I'm making this next video just for my bro, man.
Let's do it. Doug, have you met Josh yet?
No, Josh.
We met the other day.
Yeah, yeah. You guys are all cool.
Not him.
It's not about being wasteful either. He's got to find that balance. By taking care of yourself. Takes care of more than just yourself. That's the sweet spot.
We can break a one now and jump the truck in the sweet 16 wheel back on the road again.
On the road again. Just can't wait to get on the road again. What if I love is watching b-ball with my friends? I can't wait to get on the road again.
Walk the road again.
Can't wait to get on the road again.
What if I love is watching b-ball with my friends?
I can't wait to get on the road again.
It could be better. It's time to shake things up. With the Capital One Venture Card, you get double miles on everything you buy, not just airline purchases. Seriously, think of all the things you buy. Great. Is this why you asked me to coffee? Well, yeah, but also to catch up. What's in your wallet?
Hey, that's some
good. Oh, like, and it's like, he loves it here while it's supposed to be the coldest.
I almost wasn't gonna come down here because it's so cold.
Yeah.
But
so I'm happy they're letting us close at 4 so we can get here too much longer after the sun goes down. So.
Yeah, I'm just gonna. I'm a creature of habit and I like doing this ritual. So.
Yeah, it's nice to get outside even if it's.
Yeah, here's the good thing: it's sunny. You know, it might sound funny. It's zero, whatever it is,
yeah.
But at least it's sunny. Like it's pouring down snow. It's totally gray. And also we know that in a few days it could be 50 again.
Yes.
It's hard to believe it was just like 50 yesterday.
It is. Well, and it dropped so quick yesterday too while we were here. We saw it happen. Sun just disappeared. The mist rolled in. It was freezing. So, but yeah, now 50. It's weird.
It's going to be Monday. And then it's probably nice for a while. I'm not a winter person. I'm more of a spring, summer, and fall person.
Yeah. Well, yeah, the weather here is so nice for so long that you kind of forget how hard it's going to be here.
Yeah.
Until it comes back in full force like this.
Yeah, but fortunately, it's not going to be forever. It's going to be for a few days.
Yeah.
But thank you. Because, you know, even though I'm not working for Nike anymore, it's so weird. I drive for Lyft and I'm still wearing all my Nike stuff.
Yeah. I mean, it's a nice jacket, so.
Yeah, I still.
I'll probably wear it even long after I not work here.
Yeah, no, it's just you know how it is. I was with them for almost 10 years.
Yeah,
it's long time. And it's still a part of my journey, you know, so I appreciate you finding that. I didn't realize I left it. Thank you, okay. She here at Capital One, they found my night jacket. I'm recording it all for you live here. Okay, I have this mounted hands-free on my windshield. It's a heavy phone, so sometimes it actually falls. But I'm in the mountains still, going on I-70, approximately 40 minutes from my loft. I'm going to make a video for sure by the end of the day, but most likely I'm going to go to my loft, unload everything in my car because I can't go out driving. I've got my car loaded with my massage table and things from my parents' garage. I was just in my parents' house in Arizona City. I left Saturday, drove up there Saturday, arrived Sunday, stayed from Sunday till Monday afternoon, about 24 hours, basically overnight. But I had a really nice visit. I couldn't stay longer as much as I'd like to.
This is Arizona City, Arizona, about an hour outside of Phoenix, Arizona, halfway between Phoenix and Tucson. Out in the middle of the desert, kind of in the middle of nowhere.
Situation now is quite a bit different. When I was driving a truck, there was a point I put my foot down, I saved $37,000. My car was paid for, all my credit cards are paid off. I didn't have any rent or mortgage. And it wasn't that I was making a lot of money, but I didn't have that much in the way of expenses, primarily just my cell phone and whatever I spent on the road. Now, because I have my loft, I have parking, I have commercial insurance all the way down the line, plus I have a little bit of credit card debt. Not so much that I can't just put my foot down and pay off the credit cards. But the point is, I was going to work Saturday, Sunday, and Monday, and actually go see my dad or my folks today. But my friend Sophia Rashkin, who I haven't heard from in a long time. Hello everyone, this is Doug. We're on our first full day, Sophia and I. We're just sitting and she's right there. We're just in the car together. We decided to do one car. It was $20 per car. And this is Monument Valley. And this is our first full day together.
Just about anywhere else in life. It's like a classroom. It's like an office. It's a place where my memory catches up with me. It's a place where I get far enough away from my past that I'm not worried about it. And something about that makes me not even worry about my damn future, and I can be present. And then all of a sudden, my past and the future all makes hell more sense. Road trips are so good for us in the head and the heart and the spirit. And I'm ready to take one again. How about you? You want to take a road trip? I'll take my road trip. You take your road trip. And if you can't take a little road trip right now, what about a road trip you've taken in the past? Share some memories, some photos, some videos of road trips in your past where you crossed some things that turned you on, that you got an appetite for, maybe an indigestion for, the memory where memory caught up with you, where you got inspired, where maybe something happened to you on the road trip where you changed for the better. Share your favorite photos and videos with me on social media, and I'll share them with you. At Officially McConaughey, hashtag Highway to More, because that's the point of this whole gig. When we take a road trip, it's not just like we're going nowhere. We're going somewhere, hopefully trying to get more out of where we're going and be more of ourselves when we get back.
And Sophia's so awesome, you know, as I've said, I'm not going to keep saying it over and over again. I was released. I was set free with Night Transportation. So Sophia is my main soul sister that really helped me. The very first night I called her and I told her about it. And she was real compassionate. She understood that I'd be, you know, freaked out and disappointed and all kinds of emotions. But she's the one that said, why don't we reframe this? You know, you had your human mind that you wanted to drive 5 more years. And, you know, do all this, but spirit had another plan for you. And now you don't have to drive 5 more years. And that's kind of what we're working on. This is the freedom tour.
It's yours. Don't try to write good, especially in your journal. Don't try to be a good writer. Write how you feel.
Yeah,
misspell, so cuss, damn yourself, damn somebody. Go for it. Go ahead. Be real judge and jury in your journal. And when you come out, you may go, gosh, dang, that's not how I feel anymore. I'm a much more of an evolved thinker now than I was then. Well, good, bravo. A lot of that has to do because you express yourself.
And then you got to be the
rawly right
there. You got to be the witness of what you express.
Yes. And so there are many things in the book that I looked at that I was like, well, I'm not going to put that in there. Because...
fourth floor, number 406, is right around the corner here. I also have an elevator in my parking garage. I'm gonna walk by in just a few minutes. So I'm going out to the bottom floor where my mailbox is in the front door, so I have my secured entrance. I was panic. Do I have my keys? I need this fob and these keys to get in. I've already locked myself out of my apartment a couple times already. But let me go. One thing good about, I think it's June 17th, is it shouldn't be snowing as I go out the door, but it can in the winter time. So this is my life, gang. I'm walking out the door of the elevator. This is my mailbox in Arizona City, where I called home for 10 years. I had a P.O. box, didn't have a mailing address. This is what my neighborhood looked like back in the day. This is historical brick. I moved in here August of 2022 after sleeping in the front seat of my 2017 Prius touring from April to August. And I moved into the Mercantile Square loft in the middle of August after I put my application on a Friday with Donald, the superintendent, prior to Victoria being the manager. So this Mercantile Square Loft, 1590 Wincoop Street, number 406, Denver, Colorado, 80202. Now, to tell you the truth, I'm a little off schedule, meaning I work my own hours, I set my own day. And Starbucks opened at 5. There's one, two blocks in that direction, right by Capital One, the new way of banking. The other one is four blocks by Union Station. There's another one at Platte River. Doug, of course, lots to talk about. I have more to talk about than an hour worth of video and more to share, but I'll try my best to give you, the viewer, some value today, because I have this, what I'm going to share with you just didn't happen overnight. First of all, I want to show you where I am, because where I am is an 11 minute walk from my loft. So I'm going to turn the camera around. See, I'm at the REI Starbucks. See the Starbucks
this
emblem?
This is the Platte River, and this Starbucks is called the REI Starbucks on the Platte River. And the Platte River runs all the way down in this opposite direction, all the way down to Cummins Park. I'm going to read from page 3 of Matthew McConaughey's book, Green Lights, and I'm going to do it here at the Platte Street Starbucks off the Platte River. Well, Platte Street is actually technically a few blocks from here.
I just finished talking on camera right here for a long time. And part of my style, which may not work for you, is I talk on camera, I show photos, I tell stories, and I use photos and videos to tell my stories. And who knows, maybe they're not meant for you or anyone, but I seem to have my best audience with people that are in the back seat of my car, and I'm talking to them in the back seat, you know, like this, looking in the mirror. They may be my audience, not friends, not family, not people that I love, not people I thought would be interested in hearing my story. My audience might be the people I talk to in the mirror here in my back seat.
It's going to turn so many people off, or they're not going to get the point. So can I edit that in a way that is more people can understand, but it's still true to how I felt and what I believe in? So I did do some editing, and there's some stories at the beginning of I give these little quips as I open up green lights to set the table with things that I've been through, and I talk about a molestation. I talk about being blackmailed and having sex for the first time. Now, look, I'm very aware that I intentionally did not give a bunch of details on those things, okay? Why? For the sole purpose that I know that in my position, putting out a book, that was going to become a headline. Uh-huh. It's not what the book's about. So I said, for me in my life, no, I'm not going to go into details of that in the book, because that'll be put in bold print. And if I have a 30-minute conversation, someone's going to want to talk about that for 10 minutes. And that's not even a third of the book.
Right.
So I was conscious of that in writing the book. But there are many things that I was like, no, you know, risk-reward, that's going to get in the way of a more important message, a more important truth that I hopefully is exposed and people can get from the book. So, yeah, there were a few of those.
I got a question for you. It might stray a little bit, but so many of our members have been with us for years, are in the business of taking their life, their journaling, their experience, their skill, their hobby, their passion, and turning it into a book, a course, a workshop, a mastermind, and that evolution that you went through. You turned journaling into something that impacted people's lives. Mm-hmm. And I know one time you said to me, so I got two questions. One's kind of just personal. One is, in that journey of kind of turning your personal stuff, I'll just ask one question at a time.
That hill, but there's no reception up there, and it's getting warm. I used to do this way earlier, but I hung out. I had a lot to think about up on top there today.
So this is where Dean lives, because he's shot video of his golf course, and he lives here, and his mastermind office is in Phoenix. And this is just a photo I found on the internet of Phoenix, the clouds and the looking down at the desert. As you probably have guessed, it does not snow there. It's very hot in the summer, because I called Phoenix home for 10 years and I was based there. It's very hot in the summer. Hi everyone, I actually have a camera on a very special person I've been talking about on my videos a lot. She's actually the dry van, your official title is a dry van terminal manager for the Phoenix terminal, which is our largest terminal. And I'm a dry van driver, and I have a manager named Erica. Erica said that she's like in charge of like something like 36 trucks. Well, she oversees all of the driver managers, okay? But she's totally awesome. So this is the first time I've done a video with her, and we've known each other for a while. And I want to mention this too, Madeline, this kind of makes it more real. I remember that first conversation we had when I was up in Salt Lake, mm-hmm. and you were on the phone, you answered the phone, and I said, are you one of the new driver managers? Because I haven't heard you. And you said, no, I'm the new terminal driver manager. I mean, yeah. That was our very first conversation.
This is my friend, LC. Who's an awesome driver. I met her outside the Phoenix terminal. And she's on our channel. Mike and I, on my Drive to Tokyo channel, interviewed LC. It was an awesome interview. Out of all the videos I have and interviews, she was the first Zoom call.
YouTube as well, because that was perfect, you know, and you kind of, you know, you feel the time limit. You know, you don't want to be on there for too long, but some people go on and do like hour long streams every day, based on whatever they're passionate about. So, you know, that's something that you could do as well. You know, just
oh, there's no doubt.
know. There's no doubt. Sorry for interrupting you, bro. What I want to say, it happens very organically for me. Like, I may sit down and really in my heart, that instant when I'm sitting down, I feel I have nothing really more to say but hello, you know? And then what happens is energy comes over me. And it's like a channel. It's just like, here I come. You're in the camera. We're rocking, bro. It just starts talking, and I'm like, okay, I'll just go with whatever we're going with. And before I know it, I've talked for 30 minutes.
Yeah, and that's what people want to see. And I don't know if you've looked into the videos over at the YouTube channel, but I've kind of like broken them up in little pieces and kind of, you know, mixed them in where, you know, you're touching on a point here about something, and then that's it. That's like one video. And then the next video can come right off of that. You know, if you send me like a 30-minute video, I can technically make like two videos off of it, because sometimes, you know, there's two different topics that I can tap into and, you know, be able to just make more content. Did you feel better recording?
I wanted to interrupt you and compliment you. I have been watching your videos, and I like the direction you're going. And I talked to you about, this is a getting to know each other, you know, getting into a flow. I figured this first week, you know, we were just gonna just flow with it. You know, we figured out the methodology was, I was gonna make the video, I was gonna send it to Facebook, you're gonna pick up, polish it, tweak it, edit it, and pass it on to the channel to get into that flow. I can see how you've grown. I can see how you've tuned into my story. You've gotten me more and more. And the videos have now, to me, gone to another level in just a few days. Like, I could see a marked improvement from the first video when you were just kind of, you know, just kind of patching things and editing, to where I could see you were getting into your zone. You were getting into, you know, doing your stuff, your intuitive stuff, and your video artistic part of you. I could see it. And then, ooh, okay. Hey, we're kind of going kind of in the direction I envisioned. Okay, so I can feel that from you. I was really, that made me feel like, well, I'm glad I made the decision to do this. I can see, this is only 5 days into it, and we still have a long ways to go. And if we're making this progress in just 5 days, we're gonna make progress every day, every week. And I can see it just, you know, so I wanted to compliment you on that. I could feel it. I could see it. I could sense it.
You may not remember it, but we had a rescue load to do, and I told you I can't do it, and I ended up racing.
Where are you going to pay?
Las Vegas, and the guy was passing it on to wasn't there.
Right.
And he got there at like 12:20, and the whole idea I did that.
I'm walking to Whole Foods, 6 minutes out my door. This is where I live, folks. It's the day after my ex-Brazilian girlfriend's birthday, I believe. What was yesterday, June 27th. I'm hoping to send this video to her so she knows about my loft. Here, there's a west side and east side. My loft is directly across the street. My parking garage is across the street. But I'm walking to Whole Foods. The light's about ready to change. It's below this high rise. It's a 6 minute walk from my Mercantile Square lot. Here we go. I'm going across right now to Whole Foods. I'm never bored here. I love watching people here. And this is where I live, gang. So I'm about ready to walk in the door of Whole Foods. It's owned by Amazon. It's called the Union Station Whole Foods. I go there at least once or twice a day. And again, I've lived in my loft since the summer of 2022. I drive for Lyft and I've done 2,500 rides. And this is my life, gang. I'm almost to Whole Foods. They're owned by Amazon. They're just right across the street from Union Station, right below these high rises. Be back. Let's go back to our regular program. I think I got back here to Denver April 20th, 1999, after my second trip to Brazil. So I wanted to tell her a little bit about my life.
Was to get there by 12 midnight. And that was our first kind of interaction. And it was like a real life thing.
Yeah.
And then I told you back then, I said, I want to be one of your best drivers. And that was
the listening audience. I'm interrupting these Zooms. I want to talk a few minutes. I just leaving Whole Foods, June 22nd. I'm going through a very important transition. It isn't just I turned 70, soon to be 71. It's just not that my father passed away and really suffered his last 8 days. It's not just that I've lost my job that I absolutely loved. It wasn't just a job, it was my whole identity. I spent $7,000 to pay Mike on my channel. My whole goal was to hit 1 million miles by age 70 something. I went to Japan 5 times in 2 years. I saved $38,000. I had a channel called Driving to Tokyo, High Performance Team, taking places you've never been before. The way I was gonna semi-retire and make money is I was gonna promote night transportation and recruit drivers, get $500 for students, $1,000 for rehires, $1,200 from other companies.
Nam yo ho renge kyo, 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 nam yo ho renge kyo.
There's probably nobody here because, well, technically right now I'm at Whole Foods, June 28th, and there's nobody here but me. And I just shaved my beard, which you probably wouldn't know. It took 2 years to grow my beard. But anyway, this is my dear, dear friend, my Nichiren Shoshu sponsor, that I met on the third trip of 5 trips to Japan below the Tokyo Skytree. And she's the one with 2 other Japanese ladies. She spoke perfect English, brought me to the Nichiren Shoshu Temple for the first time. We chanted Nam-myoho Renge-kyo after I had not practiced since I left Denver. And now we're best friends. So this exact thing we just recorded, I think it was either the day of my ex-girlfriend's birthday or the day before. And of all time, see, I was asking, when are we gonna have our next meeting, which is, she does the second prayer, which is 30 pages. Nam yo ho dengi kyo ho ben pandai ni ninji sei san anju niki shode bhaji jim nangi. She does that, and that's, it's 4th of July weekend. Now, I know Sylvie may not watch this, and that was 25 years ago, but, and Sylvie's not gonna understand because she's not me, and she's not tuned into my spirit because she's not me. I don't blame her. She's 6,000 miles away. But of all the times we're going to have our next Zoom call, it's 4th of July weekend when Sylvie read from the Course in Miracles for the first time. And we became boyfriend and girlfriend. And we were boyfriend and girlfriend from 4th of July weekend. Then we broke up on the beaches of Porto Seguro. And we officially became only friends April 20th, 1999, which I guess is 25 years ago. 25 years ago. I was 45. I just wanted to share that with you while I'm at Whole Foods. Let's go back to our regular program. He can. And she, I still, I'm hoping to be friends with her because she understands Buddhism. and she's Brazilian, and she's dual citizenship, and she's a Brazilian citizen and a UK citizen. Yeah, so that'll be a special weekend. So that's July 3rd or 4th for me? July
3rd for you.
3rd for me, 4th for you. Okay. Okay, my friend. I'm so thankful for you.
Me too. Thank you.
I appreciate our friendship, and thank you for keeping your faith with me. And I look forward to us seeing each other in Japan sometime.
This year.
Yeah. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Okay, my friend. Say hi to your husband.
I see.
Okay. Okay, I'll see you the next time.
See you next week.
Okay. Okay, my friend. Goodbye.
Yeah. Bye-bye.
With the Matthew McConaughey thing.
That's awesome, man. Are you hanging out here? Or are you taking it to go?
To go. I mean, to here.
For here, let's do it.
This is my main dude. He's my favorite one. And Josh over here is like the main bartender. He does all kinds of shit.
And he's the best.
And so I'm doing nachos. Hello, Tokyo.
Hello, Tokyo.
Matthew McConaughey. I'm still trying to introduce you to my main dude here.
Dude, I would love to meet Matthew McConaughey.
No, Matthew, I really get, because I'm still grooving down my path, dude.
Yeah. Dude, I'm so happy for you, man. I'm so happy you're making those videos still and you're doing everything. So.
Even though nobody's watching them, I still
make them. Hey, I'm watching them. Every now and then, man, I get on there and I see him. I'm like, I wonder what Doug's up to. I wonder what his last video was.
Have you noticed me?
I'm noticing.
Okay. I love this dude. Because he's a young dude. I'm like 69 fucking years old.
But you don't look or act 69. Though.
I don't act
69. You know?
I'm a younger dude.
Yeah, I feel it. You got the young energy.
I'm like a 30-something year old in a 69-year-old body.
Exactly.
And that's the key to life, dude.
It is.
And look at, you're just going for it. I didn't even tell you what to put in here.
Oh, I already know. What kind of meat you doing, though? That's the big one.
I guess I could do chicken.
Let's do chicken.
It doesn't really matter, to be honest with you.
Doug likes it all.
Yeah, I like it all.
He likes
it. Hey, everything. I want you to know, folks out there in the listening audience, Chicago, Takako, Kyoto, Kazuto, Hoi, Chikoyo, Cho, Hoi, Kazuto, Hoi, Huizuro. This is like the main American dude here. Like, hi, Kazuto, hi. Hi!
You do just queso, right? Or you do both?
Yeah, we could do both.
Let's do both.
So if we have anybody coming from Tokyo, dude. And here's my dream. My bucket list thing.
What's your bucket list
thing? I want to bring Matthew McConaughey here.
Dude, let's do it. I'm down. I'm always down.
You know, that's my dream. To bring Matthew McConaughey to meet Josh in the back kitchen here.
Hear that?
Josh! Yeah. I want, my main goal before I died, bro, is to bring Matthew McConaughey here in here to meet you.
That would be sick. I would love to meet Matthew McConaughey.
He's a cool dude, from what I know.
I'm sure he is. I can imagine. He's probably, yeah. How's that going? It's going well?
It's going well. I'm still on the Matthew McConaughey things. Tony Robbins and Matthew and Dean just did a major thing. Just 4 days ago, 2 hours a day, is called Own Your Future.
Ooh, what's that about?
It's about being the best version of yourself, and that's what I'm trying to do, dude.
That's awesome, man. I could tell. You're always trying to do...
the next level, dude.
You're trying to do what you want to do, but you're trying to do it...
Next level, man.
Yeah.
And, bro, I'm trying to inspire you because you're a young dude. You said you're a music engineer?
Yeah, I do music stuff. I do music production stuff, yeah.
And my best friend, Christopher Stone, is a sound engineer.
Really?
Yeah.
That's awesome, man.
And I want you to meet him. I'm going to pay for his fucking airline ticket to come and meet you.
Hell yeah. Where does he live?
He lives in Mount Shasta, California.
Oh, California.
I'm going to make a video with some of his production stuff.
Yeah,
if
man.
You go to YouTube, type in Christopher Stone.
Christopher Stone.
I'm standing at my street corner. This is my friend Bloom from Illegal Pete's. We've had many conversations at Illegal Pete's. And I'm about ready to cross the street to my lock entrance right over here. I'm standing right where my friend Gentry place, and this is where I live in the heart of Lower Downtown. Here we go. All right, all right, all right. I'm gonna cross the street. Here we go, here we go. All right, all right. There's a bike thing, but I know it's gonna turn green right now because I live here. I know what to happen. See green right now. I'm in the groove. I have a front entrance and an alley entrance, and Illegal Pete's is right over there where I'm talking to Bloom. So let's go back to Bloom and I talking about Matthew McConaughey. Right around the corner from where I live here in Denver, Colorado. Okay, you'll see his shit.
Oh shit, hell yeah, I'm excited, man.
Yeah.
You just do the nachos, you don't want to drink, you don't want anything fun? Cooking, nothing like that?
I guess I'm going to do this. I can't believe I bumped into you again.
I know, man. I'm excited. I love seeing you here in the mornings. I didn't know you came in the morning.
No, awesome. Because I wanted to see you, bro.
Oh, thanks, man. I appreciate
you're
it.
You're on the lows in the back. I got to tell, because we don't have any customers waiting for us right now. Most people are camera shy.
I'm pretty camera shy still. I'm a little camera shy. For
you
sure.
Could be an actor, bro.
I don't know about that.
I hope because I get connected, Matthew, he discovers you.
Hey, that would be, I'll take it. I will gladly take it if that's the case.
Well, let's put that on our thing to do.
Let's do it.
Everything in place, and it took about a minute micro sleep. Imagine, I worked 13 years from zero, rebuilt my life. Saw my parents every single month for 13 years. Went home every single month and told my parents how much I love night transportation and how much I've felt so good about rebuilding my life. And then it took a minute. I don't even know what it is. A micro sleep, if you're not familiar with it. See, the corporate people like Madeline, who's on my channel, was really tight with, drive-in terminal manager, they go to work at 7, they get off at 5. They have kind of a, I don't really have really normal life, but what I'm saying is they don't travel.
This is Sylvia and I when I was 45. The first trip to São Paulo, Brazil, after we met online in spring of 1998. We became boyfriend, girlfriend on 4th of July weekend.
This is me. I was one of the first cab drivers at DIA. Now it's 28 years old. I was probably 40 something. I started driving a cab, I think, when I was 42. And went to Brazil for age 45, and now I'm driving for Lyft at age 70. What's that?
For my family.
I don't have any money, I'm sorry. Sorry.
Sorry.
Lo siento. Anyway, there's a lot of Venezuelan people here. Unfortunately, I probably should start carrying money, but anyway, back to my point. This is not an excuse, and especially, hear me out. I've got Matthew McConaughey, Academy Award winning actor as of April 24, 2023, my dad's last birthday, author and actor, Tony Robbins and Dean Graziosi as my three mentors. 3-minute video. I'm sharing it with you, the viewer, for a specific reason. This is the terminal that I worked out of for 10 years. I loved it. You'll see a woman walking through the terminal dressed in black. That's Madeline, who is the terminal manager of the drive-in fleet that I was a part of. This is the remodeled, upgraded terminal. My last load specifically was number 5, 2021. I picked up a drop-in hook, paper load, and Spokane, Washington. Did my arrived at shipper call, dropped the empty, picked up the preloaded trailer, checked out, left at 2 a.m. Took my first, well, actually
first of two breaks in Beaver, Utah, Flying J, just south of the I-70 where it comes into the 15, north, south, Salt Lake City, south of Las Vegas, Los Angeles, and San Diego. I did my pre-trip at 2 o'clock a.m., stopped at my fuel stop. Right after my fuel stop, about 4 in the morning, I had a micro sleep. I got stuck in the mud. Had to call breakdown, get towed out. Called dispatch at 7, did my last break in Flagstaff, three hour drive north of Las Vegas. Dropped a load in the terminal. I'm sharing this because when I dropped a load 2.5 years ago, the terminal was a mess. We still had a garage and we still had the driver lounge and we had operations, but there was talk of a bowling alley and basketball court. Here's the deal. If I hadn't had that micro sleep, who knows, but most likely I'd be driving now, had hit my million miles, and I'd be working out of this terminal. We had terminals in Southern Cal, Central California, Tulare, Portland, and we had terminals in West Salt Lake, Las Vegas, El Paso, Dallas, Houston, Kansas City, all over the country. But this is the best and biggest terminal. I still love Knight, even though it fired me, and it will forever. My friend Sophia said it best. She said, you're not gonna let the decision they made in the last 24 hours of your employment tarnish or ruin your 10 years of memory. Tony Robbins talks about the same thing. It's not that you're denying that something happened, but when you remember something that was 99.99% positive, don't let the decisions of other people completely sabotage your memory of a very positive experience. This is Knight Transportation. I'll forever love Knight, be proud that I was a driver and drove 750,000 miles, made them $1 million. My whole channel was devoted to promoting Knight Transportation. So this is the Knight terminal where I'd be working out of right now. But I still worked out of it. It just was a mess when I was there because the parking lot was all torn up. But this is also where I met my friend LC. Check this out. I drove 200,000 miles to Kona. After coming back, after being in Japan 2 months, October 2019 to December 2019, they gave me a brand new T680 Kenworth $140,000 truck. I drove it 2 years through COVID after I came back from Japan. I'll forever love and treasure my, I started driving with CRST at age 55. And also it was almost 15 years I got to see my mother and father, my dad, and my dad would drive down from Big Bear City to pick me up at the CRST yard when he was 75 and I was 55. Lots of really treasured memories with trucking, including almost 10 years with Knight Transportation. Unfortunately, in my Mercantile Square loft, I have two really barking dogs that bark at everything. It's probably the only negative of my place. This dog barks when I talk, barks when I leave my apartment, and it barks right next door. That's one of the reasons I moved my bed out in the living room to make a soundproof, hopefully non-barking dog video studio. But right now, right in the middle of my videos, the dog barks. Now, the truth is,
I can take out the barking dog and put music or voiceover later, but it does get to be a little bit much after a while. But I have barking dogs. Other terminals we have, for example, Las Vegas has the same amenities, a secured parking lot, driver lounge, shower, operations, laundry, basic stuff, but it's much smaller. This is the largest terminal. And when I watch this, it may not mean anything to you, but I think I came this close to driving still today. I was planning on driving until I was 75, and now I'm 70. So when I see this, what I see is my old terminal and the finished remodeling project that, when I was there, it was right smack in the middle of everything being torn up. So it means maybe a little something more to me than it would you watch this video. This is the back of Madeline, who I have a 20-minute interview with Madeline. This is Madeline, the drive-in terminal manager, who I was really tight with. I would consider her a friend. I saw her every time I came back from home time, every time I left during regular business hours. She was awesome. This is Madeline walking through the terminal. Have for about a year. I belong to, I want to introduce you to my mastermind family. I have a Nichiren Shoshu sponsor who's been practicing Nichiren Shoshu Buddhism for 35 years, who loves me. We're real tight. We do regular Zoom calls. I have a loft for 50% off. I have an electric car where I can work any hours I want to. Here's the deal. Can I be honest with you? This is what Dean talks about. We all, myself included,
sabotage ourselves. We all have two voices in our head. We all, I call my sub dude. I tell you my customers this. My customers, my riders get in the car and I tell them right up front that I have a sub dude. I tell them right up front that I was a land pilot and a land astronaut, and I tell them up front that I make videos, and I tell them up front I made over 3,000 videos and I delete most of them. I tell them up front this phone right here that my Lyft app is on is the center of my universe. But I also tell them up front I don't make any money. And I also tell them that the way I make my money, and I have to make my money, if I don't do it, I'm in trouble. But do you know what I love about where I live compared to Arizona City? I can just go outside and just feel, just walking, watching people. I mean, men and women. And this, I gotta tell you, can I be real with you? Marijuana is legal here. Mushrooms, the demographics here are all people in their 20s and 30s. This is like the Amsterdam of the U.S. Now, can I be honest with you? When I drove a truck, we had random drug tests, and I couldn't drink any alcohol when I was out. And I came home, although I love my parents, I came home to a little town that had one signal light. Nowhere I like to hang out. I didn't make a single friend. So on this video, I don't have much time left. I want to show you the part of me when I'm around people, whether it's my 2,500 riders that you can't see. See, I'm not videotaping them, but imagine I've been with 2,500 people. And all my people skills came out that I had driving a cab. Now, there was a point when Sylvia H. Santos met me. She said I was handsome, intelligent. She fell in love with me on 4th of July weekend about 26 years ago. But I was 45. But I think I'm actually a cooler dude. So here, can I be honest with you? Arizona City didn't make a single friend. Now I've got an apartment. I've got to work 16 hours a day between now and fall. Why? I can't just get by. I can't. That's why I sold my 2017 Prius Tour and got 11,400. That's why I have the electric car I have now. I've got to take full advantage. Plus, I have to get serious about my chanting. But I think, I'm not saying it's going to happen, but I will say there's probably a higher probability I can actually finally have a relationship again. And I got to tell you, being in love, especially with someone that stays in love with you, you know, my mom and dad, that's what I love about them. They've been married since high school. Till death do you part. And my mom was holding my dad's hand to the very end. My mom was holding my dad's hand when his eyes were closed. He couldn't eat, he couldn't talk. He was shutting down, and she was talking to him to the very end. My mom and dad, I couldn't have better parents. So the point is, I have no excuses, even being 70. And this is it. This is the potentially last decade of my life. So if I don't get my shit together, see, in Buddhism, the belief is it's not how you start your life, it's how you end your life. And frankly, I don't have any excuses. That's the bottom line. Let's go back to our regular program.
Personal conversation. So I put that intention out there, but I didn't really know you that well. And then what caught my eye is your messages that you started sending out to the fleet. Like really cool messages about consciousness, and you got to take care of your vision.
Yeah, and your mindset.
Your mindset. And I'm like, she's a different type of drive band manager. And so that's what I'm excited about. And the last thing I want to mention, one of the reasons I stay with Night Transportation is because of people like Madeline and the culture here. So I'm not going anywhere. So she said she's a little shy. You know, and I didn't like myself on camera, so I'm just going to ask a couple questions. She's going to be completely herself. So here's question number one. Why did you, they're very easy questions. Okay. Why did you decide to go into trucking? How did that happen? And specifically, you know, night transportation.
This is really easy.
Yeah.
Thanks for starting out with an easy one. My best friend, her husband works for Knight Transportation, and then he said you should come work for Knight Transportation.
Oh, that was easy. Yeah.
I know, I said it was really easy. I mean, it wasn't quite like, you know, that easy. I was doing something else before, and then there came to a point where I could make a decision to leave that. Totally not transportation related. Wow. I mean, I came in with zero, I mean, I don't think anyone outside of the industry really knows about it, which is like kind of weird because you would think everyone should know about it. We all rely on it pretty heavily.
Exactly, good point.
And so, but it's pretty wild because, you know, I didn't even think about like, even just the distance it takes to stop a tractor trailer, you know, or speed up, or, you know, like just even driving around it physically, but then kind of just the figurative aspects as well, like, oh, that, you know, the stuff ending up on shelves in a store, like, how did it get there?
Exactly.
And so, you know, just like really thinking about that. And so I came in literally knowing nothing about transportation. I started as a driver manager on this team, and then quickly I moved over to the account management team. I managed a national account, and I did that for a year, and then I moved over to another account management team, and I managed all the account managers, and then now I came back into operations, and I took over as the terminal manager here. And so, but yeah, it was kind of just like a, sure, let's try it out, and then it worked out.
Fall, winter, and spring are very nice. About 8 months out of the year, it's very nice. And it's about a 7-hour drive to Los Angeles. And from my folks' house, it's only about a 5.5-hour drive to San Diego and the ocean. So that's why some people love Phoenix and love Phoenix area, because it's not far from Southern California. And it's really beautiful in its own way.
And I'm like, I'll just go live from up here. And then there was no reception, so I had to find a spot that wasn't in the sun, didn't bug other hikers, and be able to share it with you guys. But I just had a message in my heart.
I shaved my head, but kept my beard. I'm walking in Cummins Park, May 27th, 2024. For those of you that are my Lyft riders that live in Denver, you know probably where Platt Street is. This is Cummins Park on a beautiful day. And you can see it's very, lots of dogs. It's a dog park. It's a holiday weekend, so there's lots of people out because it's Monday, the holiday. Got some scooters going by right now. And on the other side. Well, if you're watching this video, there's a strong possibility you're gonna know that this is Doug, but you may not recognize my long beard because I have many of friends that have not seen my long beard. However, the exception may be if you're one of my Lyft riders, has either been one of my 2,400 riders who have ridden in my 2017 Prius Touring in the last 2 years, you may recognize me because I'm your main dude, your Lyft driver. Now,